Rex Georg seems to worry about it being cold in the van, but it's lovely. I mean, with all the insulation and my body heat and a lovely warm duvet, I'm okay down to about 7 Celsius in here, and it's still toasty in the back of the van at night. I know I'm parked on an industrial estate, and therefore whoever's doing this thinks it's a really good place, but there's someone nearby just revving his engine really hard, just vroom, vroom, vroom. I'm trying to watch YouTube videos. Do you mind? I just looked at my statistics for my YouTube channel, and I was absolutely shocked that my most recent video, which in my timeline is the video, got an average attention span of 9 minutes and 22 seconds. Well done, Socks with Sandals Army. Do a shave. Now, last year, the death rate was normal for any year. This year, it's higher. Do you know what's different? What's different about 2021 compared to 2020 is what I'm not allowed to tell you on any fake news or big tech platform. Just got my laundry. 2 great big bags worth. Delta variant. So now, every item of textile I have is clean, including bedding, except what I'm wearing. So I just booked my van in for an MOT, and the guy at the reception, so, you know, started going on about my timing chain and this and that, and I said, oh, it's okay, you know. And he said, oh, but for the diesel test now, they have to rev it as high as it will go. You know, I'd never driven it above 4,000 RPM. I don't even know if it revs higher than that. So it could be part of this new freaking global warming thing to try and destroy as many diesel cars as possible. That is a lovely 1976 V-dub bus there. Very nice. Ordinary. Wow, flying fish in the restaurant. That's just brilliant, isn't it? I have begun to binge watch another YouTuber. Now this guy, he's a bit like me, but a lot more popular. In other words, he's got that kind of authentic van life stuff, but the van isn't really the focus. It's more about, you know, the people he meets along the way, you know, and the reminiscence of the time past, and also he does some bonkers collaborations with other people, and he does like that screen rants thing, or the Julie Nolke thing, you know, where he pretends to be more than one person in the same scene, or playing off himself in a scenario, you know, does that, so you never quite know what you're going to get with him. So it's a bit like, I don't know if you ever watched It's All Right on the Night, which is like you watch video outtakes and bloopers, and then you try and watch something else after that. You're a little bit disorientated because you think, you know, why aren't things going badly wrong for everybody all the time kind of thing? Well, it's a bit like that with him. You might binge watch like five joke sketches in a row, and then after that, you know, he's kind of visiting his hometown and seeing his old mates and his mum, and you never quite know what you're going to get next. And in a way, I kind of understand how you guys feel watching me. So yeah, I thoroughly recommend Joel Haver. Link at the end as well. What is that racket? Aha! Lawnmower. Oh, God. I've fallen into a bit of a hole recently. I think just the weight of the world got on top of me. I haven't got up before midday for a couple of weeks. I haven't done any exercise. I haven't eaten any fruit or vegetables. I only eat or drink when I'm absolutely thirsty or starving. It's just the waiting, you know, because I've just been ready for this end game ever since I bought all that underfloor storage 9 months ago, put the solar panel on my roof. Well, in one form or another, months and months ago. Just think, for God's sake, you know, just roll out the bloody roadblocks and ban all vehicles and ban all movement of people and just build the camps, you know, just ready, because I've got my plan in place. I'm just waiting for the go, you know, because there's no point in like disappearing to some remote mountain in Wales with a source of drinkable water when it's still safe to hang around in civilization. And I don't think I'm the only one either. There must be millions of people around the world who figured out what's happening and that they're going to survive this, and they've got their plan in place. They know exactly what they're going to do depending on which scenario is rolled out in which order, and they're just ready for every stage of it. Just bring it on. Bring it on. And I think, really, the globalists have been panicked because they didn't anticipate populism and the Great Awakening, the global elevation of human consciousness that has occurred simultaneously alongside the deliberate development of the technocracy to a point where the takeover would be possible. So it's going to be close, but I don't think this is going to be a clean fight at all. Nah, this is going to be one big mess. Even if we survive this, and I know a lot of you have looked long and hard into that dark void and figured out some way to navigate it, but good luck to you.